featuring our bel canto singers, our chamber choir, and members of our FLHS a cappella program. Thank you so much for being with us this evening. I know it's not in person as far as having an audience, but we are thrilled to finally be singing in person together in one space, the first time in 15 months. So I think we all would say that we are welcoming this change. We see the light at the end of the tunnel, and hopefully this time next year we will have you in person with us. But we have these incredible acoustics. We have built-in live streaming. Maybe that's the only silver lining out of this pandemic. So we are bringing this concert to you in your homes. You have been given a program if you check your email and you want to follow along with the list of the repertoire, the soloist names, our senior names. Please do check in with that program. Also, there are links to our Facebook page, which is brand new, our YouTube channel, and hopefully you can pass that along to family and friends along the way. I will introduce all the tunes as we come up. In case you don't have access to that link right away, I will post it and this entire concert at the end of the evening permanently on our YouTube channel. We are going to start with a tune that is super important to our bel canto singers because this is a brand new ensemble. As of just 2 years ago, we had 3 levels of choir, but as our growing program grew, we had 175 students. We needed to build another ensemble to fit the masses. So we created Bel Canto Singers, which stands for Beautiful Singing. And we thought, what better way to kick off the program but by having a special piece commissioned for this group. So we got together with a colleague, Steve Danu, and we actually had the students come up with the text themselves. We set it to music, and unfortunately we did not get to premiere it at last year's Greenfield Hill Congregation performance, so we are going to debut it today. It is Our Light by Steven Danu. Thank you. Our next tune was actually brought back from a few years ago. We sang Witness at our choral festival 3 years ago. So half the group had already known it and begged to bring back a favorite. And then it was fun to teach some of the new chamber members. So this is a traditional African-American spiritual rearranged by Jack Halloran. And we hope you will enjoy it as much as we do. Our next tune is a tradition that we upheld every time we sing at Greenfield Hill at the end of the year. We put together a tune just by ear. So we picked Stand By Me by Benny King. We have featured soloists Katie Sicleri and Maddie Valentino, and they will be accompanied by all as an a cappella tune.
Da 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 should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry and stand by you.
So this song needs a little introduction. At the end of the year, around the springtime, I let my upper levels choose a piece of repertoire to study. Now I set some parameters, must be have educational value, right? But then they have to create a sales pitch. They have to sell it to their classmates and they have to sell it to the teacher. And then we take a class vote on our favorite tune. So Bel Canto chose our next tune, which is called Soft Place to Land from Waitress.
Sugar, butter, flour. Sometimes I still see her, my mother, the dreamer. She'd say nothing's impossible, child.
Thank you.
tune Shake It Out, you might remember it from the radio, Florence and the Machine. And we actually had an alumni, Alexander Subrobra, who arranged this for us a couple years ago and helped win us a competition, I think about 3 years ago. So this was a favorite that we decided to bring back as well. Shake It Out, we are going to be featuring Victoria Fox, Gabby Tavolato, and Anna Morin. All right, welcome back. It is time for our recognition of our choir members and our seniors, senior awards. But I'm gonna start with recognizing those who participated in our CMEA festivals. So every student gets a certificate if they auditioned for and participated in a festival. So we're gonna start with our Western regions and then move on to our all-state recognition. When I call your name, please come get your certificate, starting with Grace Camara. Sylvie Cimino. Brennan Clark. Kyle Garyak. Ella Magnuson. Anna Morin. You're welcome. Vincent Owe. Gavin Schlinghide. Katie Sicleri. Gabby Tavolato. So despite it being a COVID year and online auditions, those were fun, weren't they, this year? We had some of the highest numbers of participants. Next, if you placed into the Western regions, you had the opportunity to audition for the all-state level. So the participants of the All-State Festival, Grace Camara. Sylvie Cimino. Brennan Clark. Kyle Garyak. Ella Magnuson. Anna Morin. Gavin Schlinghide. Katie Sicleri. All right, so it goes Western Region, then it goes All-State, then every other year it's All-Eastern, and this year was All-Nationals. The first time we've had a recipient go all the way, Sylvie Cimino. Congrats. All right. Now, something new I'm doing this year, you all know we kind of came up with senior superlatives. So I polled the class, and I made everybody come up with some adjectives to describe their friends and superlatives, and then I compiled them together, yes? And I made you a beautiful paper plate award.
Oh, they're so pretty!
I did that. My intern helped. All right, so each senior, this is the time where I get to embarrass you. So sorry, not sorry. I also have these incredible gifts for you. The MPA went above and beyond this year. I only know the half of what's in them. It's some good stuff this year, isn't it? Okay, MPA went above and beyond. Please do not lose them. They don't have your names on them, so you hang on tight to those goodies in there, okay? All right, bear with me. The first up, alphabetical, you know who you are. Come on up. Max Beck, everybody. Okay, you have to stand here while I read out for your own superlatives to everybody. Okay, shh, they're all wonderful. You are most likely to be secretive or quiet during class and rehearsal. You brighten the day. You say thank you. You're the first to say thank you. And you are the first to finish an assignment. The adjectives apparently we don't agree. The adjectives used to describe you are talented, both musically and visually. We've seen you doodle. You're focused, committed, responsible, creative, funny, kind, and polite.
Aww, you're welcome.
All right, Tara. You can decide which side you want to be on to be. Okay. Tara is most likely to brighten the day, have a positive attitude, say thank you, and help a friend in need. Adjectives to describe you, you're kind, fun, caring, friendly, talented, smart, organized, focused, motivated, helpful, approachable, and polite.
You're welcome.
Wait, Tara.
That's okay.
All right, next year you all have to come back and give me hugs, yes? Okay, I want hugs next time. All right. Brennan! Brennan's gonna stand over there. He does one thing. All right. Brennan, this will come to no surprise to anyone. You are most likely to.
Be a runner.
end up on Broadway. Okay. Brighten the day. Continue in an a cappella group. And you get along with others. You are smart, knowledgeable, talented, confident, hilarious, cheery, happy, outspoken, outgoing, and talkative.
You're welcome.
Justin! Also not surprising, most likely to be, it was a tie, be a famous musician or win a Grammy. I mean, they kind of go hand in hand. It is what it is. You're most likely to chat during rehearsal. So good luck getting that Grammy. Yeah, yeah, okay. Or be a stand-up comedian.
Oh.
Can you win a Grammy for that? I don't think you're gonna get a Grammy for that. All right. You are so extremely talented in everything musical, technologically savvy, that's a big word for me, funny, charismatic, and oh so talkative.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Kyle Dutter. All right, Kyle, you are most likely to drop a beat, have your earphones in, be constantly humming, you are always humming, and be glued to your phone. You are kind, funny, polite, dedicated, passionate about music, and oh so talented at beatboxing. Thank you, Kyle. Ryan. Also a no-brainer, most likely to be on Broadway. She brightens the day. You're also most likely to be a teacher. So if it doesn't work out for you on Broadway, you're also likely to be the first to class. You are talented, passionate, confident, outgoing, prepared, focused, kind, friendly, and stylish. Ella Magnuson. All right, Ella is most likely to, be a dancer. I don't think I put that as an option, but that would have been. Brighten the day, has a positive attitude, always be smiling. That was like across the board. Most likely to be a teacher and most likely to say thank you. You are talented and creative in music, dance, and art. Kind, fun, talkative, cheerleader, helpful, a leader, motivated, and dedicated. Katie McElwee. All right, Katie, you ready? Most likely to come to class with a coffee. You're most likely to brighten the day. It's true. We always have these moments, right? We like laugh. You're most likely to procrastinate, and you're most likely to help a friend in need. Talkative, friendly, outgoing, exciting, funny, always happy, kind, warm, and compassionate. Vincent! Okay, Vincent is most likely to continue in an a cappella group. I hope so. Be a composer.
Okay.
Be a public speaker.
Okay.
It's true. It's true. He has a way with words. And help a friend in need. You are talented, musical, smart, creative, organized, funny, hilarious, calm, and cool-headed. Catherine. Yeah. All right, Catherine. You are most likely to brighten the day. It's true. Be prepared and be the first to finish an assignment. Yes, yep. I would agree. And the first to say thank you. You are focused, driven, funny, kind, sunny, smiley, smart, athletic, and enthusiastic and well-spoken. All right, Sarah Burke. Most likely to be in a music video. Most likely to be quiet in a rehearsal. Most likely to help a friend in need. And most likely to be glued to your phone. Adjectives: fashionable, fashionista, stylish. They just kept going. I know they're all the same, but they kept going. Creative, kind, sweet, chill, the next Gwen Stefani. Likely to be a fashion designer or model. Ooh. Ellen. All right, Ellen, this was a unanimous vote. You are most likely to brighten the day. The second close second was to say thank you all the time. Most likely to become a professional dancer or choreographer, and most likely to be late to class. Okay. Always. Bubbly, cheerful, sweet, funny, organized, prepared, and creative. You will hit all the high notes, and you will always make us laugh. Victoria! Victoria's most likely to
be a singer.
Okay, be a pop star, famous musician, songwriter, or win a Grammy. One of those, okay? Also most likely to be in an a cappella group. You are driven, dedicated, talented, kind, smiley, chatty, friendly, outgoing, confident, and positive. Victoria! You're welcome. Emerson! Emerson, you are most likely to have a positive attitude. Be prepared, help a friend in need, and be a composer, musician, teacher. You are smart, reliable, kind, funny, smiling, generous, a multitasker, and overall talented. You're welcome. Caitlin! Caitlin is also most likely to end up on
Broadway!
Or a public speaker, motivational speaker. Would you go with that one? Maybe. She's prepared, and she always has a positive attitude. Smart, talented, motivated, kind, happy, funny, prepared, has her life together. And most likely to get a massage after school. Caitlin! Anna!
Yay!
Anna is most likely to be secretive or quiet during rehearsal. She is going to be a public speaker or motivational speaker. She will continue in an a cappella group. And she's most likely to catch a teacher in error. She's admirable, intelligent, determined, sweet, funny, kind, friendly, classy, talented, a leader, and always has a coffee. Whitney! Whitney, you know what I'm gonna say. Most likely to come to class with a
coffee.
We talk about coffee, Whitney and I, all the time. You're also likely to catch a teacher in error and be the first to finish an assignment, and you are prepared. You're also intelligent, organized, energetic, poised, motivated, stylish, cool outfits, good vibes, quick-witted, and a girl boss. Allie. Allie is most likely to be secretive, quiet during class and rehearsal. She always has a positive attitude. I did not know this next one. You like to procrastinate?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. And she's most likely to help a friend in need. Adjectives to describe you: kind, sweet, good-natured, great to talk to, approachable, intelligent, kind, caring, and compassionate. Katie? Katie is most likely to be
a teacher.
All right. Second, be a professional musician, either Broadway or Grammy, either one. You're likely to catch a teacher in error and be late to rehearsal. She's friendly, honest, kind, a role model, talented, imaginative, determined, confident, dedicated, and late to class because of coffee or its activity period. Lydia. Lydia is most likely to have a positive attitude, to say thank you, to brighten the day, and help a friend in need. Adjectives to describe you: sweet, kind, positive, sunny, welcoming, thoughtful, generous, sincere, and the best smile. Gabby. Gabby is most likely to continue in an a cappella group, it's true. Or be a famous musician, or be a country singer, very specific, or to be a leader. You are confident, hardworking, charismatic, funny, positive, intelligent, multi-talented, musical, and outgoing. Natty! All right, Maddie. You are most likely to chat during rehearsal, be late to rehearsal, but you're going to continue in an a cappella group and you have a positive attitude. You are talented, intelligent, hardworking, funny, vibrant, kind, outgoing, generous, enthusiastic, and innovative. All right. All right, so now is the time where we honor the awards. We have three award recipients. I did leak this during the Tri-M concert, but I did not get to embarrass them fully, so here we go. All right, our first award is called the National School Choral Award. It is the highest honor for high school choral performers, as it recognizes the dedication and musical achievements of the top male or female choral student. So it is no surprise that I'm giving this to Katie Siclari. Come on up. Katie made my heart skip a beat when she said she was going to go major in music education. But Katie is an extremely talented singer and musician. She's incredibly dedicated to her craft, both in and out of school. I have so enjoyed working with you these past 4 years, starting as a freshman in a very rowdy concert choir. A sophomore in treble choir, it was a quiet treble choir, quiet one, right? And then 2 years in our lovely new bel canto singers. Katie has participated in Western Regions for 3 years, Allstate for two, and has been a Tri-M member for 3 years. Katie has spent all 4 years in the a cappella program. Freshman year, you were in aria. Sophomore through senior year, you were part of Close Harmony. And this year, you stepped up to be co-student director for our a cappella program. Katie has also taken my keyboarding class, in addition to every music class I think that we offer here at Ludlow. So we practice each other every day, and you're constantly in the music wing. I will miss your beautiful voice, your incredible sight reading, your attention to detail, and your dedication to our choral program. But I look forward to working with you again as an educator in just a few short years. Let's please wish Katie best of luck at Indiana University for Music Ed. All right, the next award is called the Director's Award for Chorus. It honors the top leaders of a high school chorus, originally named after Fred Waring in honor of this man who is a musician, bandleader, radio, TV personality, all of the above. So this recipient has characteristics that epitomize precision, sensitivity, and enthusiasm. We have two recipients. First is Justin Doe. We all know Justin for his stunning and mature voice, as well as his knack for music technology. We also know that Justin refuses to believe me when I say that he is not a bass. He just has an incredible vocal range. All kidding aside, Justin is incredibly passionate about music and brings nothing but professionalism to his performances and music studies. Justin quickly moved up to chamber singers after an equally rowdy freshman year in concert choir. He also joined Close Harmony and Tri-M for the latter few years. And I will forever remember the music videos that Justin has created for us, starting with The Prayer in last year's talent show. He sang a duet with himself and learned the Italian in what, 24 hours?
Yeah.
I think so. And then last week's performance, if you haven't seen it, a change is going to come. I will never forget the many times that you've dropped by just to say hi, to shop talk, or to share a random recording that you've been working on and wanting feedback for. You are quick-witted, focused, driven in so many things, but especially in music. And what's even more remarkable is it just comes naturally. Don't make me cry. Despite him pursuing a non-music degree, which we will not hold against him, we must also congratulate him for receiving a scholarship because he was selected as one of three students to be part of the Catholic Liturgical Music Scholars Program at DeSales University. Please help me congratulate Justin in his music efforts at Ludlow and beyond. Our next recipient is Ellen Downard. Just as your peers promoted you for likely to brighten the day, so has Ellen brightened up each ensemble that she has been a part of. You were also part of that really rowdy concert choir. All my seniors were, right? Remember? Oh my gosh. It's why I moved concert choir to first period, because you guys were so loud. A sophomore in treble choir, and you were asked to skip up to our newest ensemble of bel canto for your junior and senior year. Not only has Ellen been a section leader and strong vocalist, but she has been our resident choreographer, both in a cappella and in bel canto. And I might be a bit biased, but the Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy remains one of my favorite bel canto moments because we bonded over music and dance. Ellen has also been a section leader in a cappella, starting with Aria, our sophomore and junior year, as well as recently in FLHS a cappella. And she's participated in Western Regions, her sophomore and junior year, as well as Allstate. She has been a triad member for 3 years, drama club for 4 years, and shines as both a vocalist and a dancer. Ellen will be attending the College of William and Mary, majoring in English and theater, so it is without doubt that I believe you will continue singing and dancing in some format. Thank you, Ellen, for your dedication to our music program in so many capacities. We will miss your brightness, lightness, and effortless singing, and I hope to remember the choreography so I can pass it down to future choristers to come. Congratulate Ellen Downard, please. All right, I have a few more thank yous. I could not have survived my first 4 years at Ludlow. It's been 4 years, right? You guys are my freshmen that came in, full rotation, without the help of the most talented and dedicated Olivia Beniston. Olivia has been our resident accompanist for all 4 years. We have only worked with Olivia. We are so blessed to just have you jump in. Anything I throw at you, you can play so effortlessly. A brilliant accompanist, and thank you so much, and you will be sorely, sorely missed. Please congratulate Olivia. She is going to MIT next year. All right, I do have a couple other thank yous. As we know, this year was quite trying during the pandemic, and I did have a few students who stepped up to be leaders. First and foremost, we were trying desperately to keep our a cappella program going, virtually speaking, and I could not have done this without our epic cheerleader, Gabby Tavolato. Gabby, I'm not done embarrassing you yet. Gabby single-handedly just reined the troops together, made sure everybody was practicing, encouraged everybody to attend our really boring virtual rehearsals. And so you really made the group stay together and would not have survived if it was not for you. So thank you so much. Okay. And I did mention co-director because we equally have to thank Katie Sicleri. We're also okay. Keeping everybody in line, section leading. I know both of you texted a million times and have group chats and get everybody in line behind my back. It's brilliant. Thank you. Please pass that down to the next group. Thank you so much. Thank you, Katie. All right, my final announcement. We do have one more award. So every year, the MPA, you know, that Music Parents Association, they get together and they pool funds from their many fundraising events, and we offer a scholarship. This year, it is called the MPA Choir Distinction Award, and we would like to give this scholarship to Katie Siclary. All right, my last thank yous are to Greenfield Hill Congregational Church for letting us use their space so much this year. My thank yous to Brett Silbert for running the show. Thank you, Brett. Absolute lifesaver. And we will take two, and we will be in places for the top of Act Two. Thank you. Seniors, make sure you tuck your things away in a safe spot. Don't lose them, please.